I was sitting in his office one day and talking to his very pretty secretary and not doing any work. And I just reached above behind me. It's literally true. And there were all his theses for previous students. And I pulled one out, and it was one on slime moulds. And I just couldn't believe it. And so I immediately started reading it, and it was by Kenneth Raper, who had got his degree, his PhD, about 10 years earlier than I did. And it was absolutely wonderful. So that's what I wrote to Ken, and he immediately responded with cultures and everything else. And at that time, there were only two people in the whole of the world who were working on those cellular slime moulds. And it was only a few others crept in the next 10 years or so. But then the thing that happened is that when molecular biology came in to the fore, then instead of having, I had a graph showing this, instead of having five or so papers per annum that were on slime moulds, it suddenly went to 120. It was the beginning of the slime moulds. But I mean, I already though, I knew I wanted to work on some organism like that, and I was actually searching for it. And there are a lot of good possibilities, but this is the best.